Welcome. This video explains the entire assembly procedure for NRS Release Mobile Warehouse 10x32. This video is in English. Other languages available are French, Spanish, and Arabic. Assembly should be undertaken by 6 individuals and a supervisor. All assembly operations can be done manually with the tools provided. We recommend that you also cross-reference with our manual. During this video, the relevant page number is shown on screen. A timer indicates real-time progress at 10-minute intervals. Unpack all boxes and packages and place the contents on the ground next to the tent assembly site. Place the first ground peg at point A. Place the second ground peg at point B at a distance of at least 34 meters. String a rope between the two points and make taut. Place the first base plate inside and adjacent to the rope at point A. Then place 8 more base plates along the rope 369 centimeters apart, separated by wall tension bars. Connect the wall tension bars onto the base plates. Hold in place temporarily with linch pins. Place a new ground peg at point D, exactly 1,005 centimeters to the right of point A. Place a new ground peg at point C, exactly 1,005 centimeters to the right of point B. String a rope between the two points and make taut. Place the first base plate inside and adjacent to the rope at point D. Place a second base plate and connect to the first with a wall tension bar. Check that the length of the diagonal between the base plates at points D and B is exactly 3,314 centimeters. Note, measure from the top left corner of the point D base plate to the bottom right corner of the point B base plate. Check that the length of the diagonal between the base plate at point A and the second base plate on line D to C is exactly 1,031 centimeters. Note, measure from the top right corner of the point A base plate to the bottom left corner of the second base plate on the line D to C. Then place 8 more base plates along the rope, 369 centimeters apart, separated by wall tension bars. Then place 8 more base plates along the rope 369 centimeters apart, separated by wall tension bars. Check that the lengths of the diagonals between the base plates at points A and C and B and C are exactly 3,314 centimeters. Anchor all base plates with ground pegs. Lay out the arches. Each arch consists of 2x wall elements, 2x half trusses, and 1x roof apex connector. This can be done whilst anchoring the base plates is ongoing. Note, the hole in the middle of the truss must be facing the front of the tent. Note, keep one set of arch components aside for later assembly of the far gable end. Unpack the nuts, bolts, and washers in readiness for assembly. Begin the arch assembly from the left side. Place a wall element in the base plate and fasten with an M16 by 220 bolt. Note, if using an adjustable base plate, initially fix to the third hole from the top until an accurate adjustment is made later. For standard base plates, fix using the top hole. Connect a half truss to the wall element with an M12x90 bolt. Connect a roof apex connector to the half truss and fasten with two M12 by 90 bolts. connect a second half truss to the same roof apex connector with two M12 by 90 bolts. Connect the half truss to a wall element and fasten with one M12 by 90 bolt. Connect the wall element to the right base plate and fasten with an M16 by 220 bolt. Repeat this procedure for all other arches, except the last one, which should be done at a later stage. Lay out two gable columns next to the first arch. Ensure that the steel connection plate is on the underside of the arch. The nut and ring will be placed on this plate. Connect gable columns to the half trusses on the first arch using M16 by 100 bolts. Lay out gable base plates at the foot of each gable column. Note, base plates should face to the nearest side of the frame. Connect gable base plates to each gable column using M12 by 140 bolts. Attach two bracing cables with yellow hooks to the roof apex connector of arches 1 and 2. Turnbuckles must always be placed at the end closest to the ground. Attach green bracing cable to the corner joint of the first arch and connect to the base plate of the second arch. Attach green bracing cable to the corner joint of the second arch. Do not hook to the base plate yet. Lay out the gate assembly unit. Unfold the gate assembly units. Lock the steel hinges at the top of the gate columns with M12 by 80 bolts. Mount the gate assembly to the gable columns using two M12 by 140 bolts. Slide across the gate beams. Slide the door covers onto the gate beams. Ensure that you use the lower cater track of the gable column. Place the steel rings at regular intervals. Connect the door covers to the steel rings. Repeat this process for the other door. Slide the upper edge of the right gable cover into the lower cader track of the right half truss. Pull across until the lower part of the gable cover can be slid into the track of the door rail. Then pull the cover evenly across to the middle of the arch. Slide the upper edge of the left gable cover into the lower cader track of the left half truss. Pull across until the lower part of the gable cover can be slid into the track of the door rail. Then pull the cover evenly across to the middle of the arch. Connect the left and right gable covers using the lacing system and close the weather protection flap with the Velcro. Take the bottom end of the right gable cover. First, slide the left side of the cover into the right cater track of the gable column until it is aligned with the top of the wall element. Then, slide the right side of the cover into the wall element cater track. Pull down both sides simultaneously. Take the bottom end of the left gable cover. First, slide the right side of the cover into the left cater track of the gable column until it is aligned with the top of the wall element. Then, slide the left side of the cover into the wall element cater track and pull down both sides simultaneously. If using adjustable base plates, now correctly align the purlins by lifting the movable base. Reattach the wall element so that it is at the most suitable height. If you wish to install a fire alarm system, do so before erecting the arches. If you wish to install a lighting system, do so before erecting the arches. Lay out two purlins between each pair of base plates on the left of the tent. Note, the curved hook should be pointing to the front of the tent. Lay out one purlin between each pair of base plates on the right of the tent. Erect the first arch and hold in position. Erect the second arch and hold in position. Hang a first purlin to the corner joint of the first arch. Using the lifting fork hook, the other end of the purlin to the second arch. Repeat for the ridge and the other side. Attach the green bracing cable from the corner joint of arch 2 to the base plate of arch 1. Tighten both green bracing cables with the turnbuckles and lock with the counter nut. Attach the bracing cables with yellow hooks diagonally from the apex of the first arch to the corner joints of the second arch. tighten the bracing cables with the turnbuckles and lock with the counter nut. Attach the bracing cables with yellow hooks diagonally from the apex of the second arch to the corner joints of the first arch. Tighten the bracing cables with the turnbuckles and lock with the counter nut. Attach two bracing cables with yellow hooks to the roof apex connector of the last arch laid out on the ground. Attach a bracing cable with a green hook to each corner joint of the last arch laid on the ground. Erect the remaining arches and lock together with the purlins. Assemble the last arch with the apex facing the front of the tent. Attach the bracing cables to the last gable end, following the same procedure used for the first gable end. Install the gate assembly and gable covers, following the same procedure used for the first gable end. erect the last gable arch and hold in position. Attach the purlins and bracing cables following the same procedure used in the first section. Secure the structure by fastening all arches to the base plates with a second M16 by 220 bolt. Tension the left and right gable covers on both gables. Slide the tension bar on the cader of the gable cover and push all the way to the corner base plate. Lock the pin into the hole. Press down on the other end of the bar and lock to the gable column with a linchpin. Tension all gable covers in the same way. Anchor the gable base plates with ground pegs. Lay out the roof cover so that the cader strip is facing the ground. Fasten two ropes to the straps at the end of the roof cover. Throw these ropes over the tent ridge to the other side of the structure. insert the cater of the roof cover into the cater track using the aperture halfway up the wall elements. Pull the cover from the other side. When the cover reaches the far side corner, stop pulling, walk close to the tent, and continue pulling straight down. Stop pulling once the mark on the underside of the roof cover is hidden by the ridge purlin. Repeat the tensioning process on the other side of the door. Place the lower roof cover with the attached tension bar back into the cater track using the aperture on the wall element. Push the cover down towards the ground by pressing on the tension bar. Use the tension bar tool to stretch the cover by pushing down on the corners of the tension bar. Fasten the tension bar to the base plates with linchpins. Repeat for the other side of the roof cover. Repeat the tensioning process with all roof covers. However, tension the side door cover last, as it has a different tensioning procedure, and that's to be covered later. To start the tensioning process for the side door panel, first roll up the door flaps. secure open by attaching the three hooks to the upper rings. Slide the wall tension bar onto the cater track above the door. Slot the top of the vertical connection rod through the hole at each end of the wall tension bar and secure with a linchpin. Secure the bottom of the vertical connection rod to the base plate and secure with a linchpin. Repeat the tensioning process on the other side of the door. A connecting flap can be attached to this roof panel by lacing straps through the eyelets surrounding the door. Arrange mud flaps so that they lie flat on the ground in preparation for ceiling tube fixing. Place the empty ceiling tubes on top of the mud flaps. Measure a distance of 1 meter from ground level and mount the clamps at this point. tie the sealing tubes with strong cord to the clamps. Fill the tubes with water. Locking the side door. Gable doors can be closed and secured with a padlock.